Our story begins with Zacharias and Elizabeth. This elderly couple had no children, not aware of the miracles God can do. Zacharias left to work.
Goodbye, Ellie. I'll be back soon.
Okay, hurry home for supper.
Faith arise. What I see, Lord, I believe. But help my unbelief, I choose to trust you. What I feel, let faith arise. Let faith arise. For my not dead, he is alive. Oh, and he already knows my every need. Surely he will come and rescue me. I lift my eyes, for the battle has been won. My God is faithful, and every single word he said is true. You're the God of miracles.
When Zacharias got to his work, he realized there was an angel of God standing right next to him.
Whoa!
I'm Gabriel, the angel of the Lord, and I'm here to inform you that your prayers have been answered.
I'll understand this.
Oh.
Prayers? What prayers?
Prayers from you, Elizabeth, and many church elders? The prayers of small loving children, and the prayers of many good friends.
Oh, those prayers.
Yes. Now, Zacharias, can I tell you my news? You, Zacharias, husband of so-called barren Elizabeth, you are to have a son.
Me? I don't understand this. Look how old I am. I don't think this could happen.
You've spoken your unbelieving heart. I guess you won't be able to talk until baby John is born.
John?
Oh, you shouldn't be talking. That was a close one. Oh yeah, please don't feed him any strong drinks like wine or alcohol. He'll be filled with the Holy Spirit.
And with that, the angel was gone, leaving behind an absolutely speechless Zacharias. Back at her house, Elizabeth is talking to Jesus.
Lord, thank you for being here for me through the thick and thin. You truly are amazing.
In Elizabeth's 6th month of pregnancy, her cousin, Mary, was visited in the middle of the night by Gabriel, the angel.
Ye faithful, joyful and triumphant, O come, ye to Bethlehem. O come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him.
Come, my faithful, oh, come, my faithful.
look on my face, oh,
look from my faithful to Bethlehem.
What are you doing here?
Mary, Mary, I just have some or quick news to tell you, and I will be on my way.
Okay, are you gonna tell me or not?
Yes, Mary, you are going to have a son, the son. He will be the spotless lamb and the light of the world, and he is coming quite soon.
I'm a virgin. It is not biblical to have a baby as a virgin.
Go ask your cousin, Elizabeth. I just had a talk with her husband, Zacharias.
I believe. Let it be done as you have said.
Once again, Gabriel the angel was gone. Later in the morning, Mary went to talk to Elizabeth.
Ellie, you're going to have a baby?
Yes, and he jumped when he heard your voice. How did you know?
An angel came to me in the night.
I see. Have you told Joseph yet?
No, I should go do that.
Okay, see you later.
Mary walked back to her house, wondering how she would be able to tell him this news.
Joy.
sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing. Joy, joy, joy. Heaven and nature sing. Let heaven and nature sing.
It came to pass in those days, there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that his kingdom should be taxed and counted, each from his own town.
Servants, I want to tax my kingdom.
To my kingdom, you all must be taxed and counted. You all must return to your hometown to be taxed from King Herod.
Whatever you say, Your Majesty, I shall send out a decree in the morning proclaiming this.
Back at the house, Joseph and Mary hear about this decree.
All ready, Joseph?
Just about. And you?
Oh, yeah.
Does something matter, Mary?
Haven't you heard of Elizabeth's baby?
Quite a miracle, if I do say myself.
A miracle, all right. Well, I'm also going to have a son named Jesus.
Okay. This is a lot to think about. See you later, Mary.
Joseph heads back to his home to think about everything.
A baby? Who is Mary having a baby with? And how does she know it's going to be a boy? This isn't very biblical. I'm going to quietly divorce Mary in the morning.
After Joseph had made up his mind, he drifted off to sleep. But not for long. You guessed it. Gabriel the angel visited Joseph in a dream.
Joseph!
Ah!
Joseph, don't divorce Mary.
Why not? She's been lying to me.
Give me one good reason you should divorce her.
She said that an angel met her in the night.
Who do you think I am?
The angel.
You bet. What a sad excuse. Any others?
She said she was going to be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Why do you think I'm here?
To tell me the same thing.
Yeah, but it looks like my job's done.
Wait, what about Mary?
What do you think? The coast is clear. Mary already knows.
I'm going to talk to Mary.
Child is this laid to rest on Mary's lap, is sleeping, whom angels raised with them. Sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds call and angels sing. bring him incense, gold, and myrrh, comparison king, to own him, the king of kings. Salvation brings to loving hearts and thrones. Raise, raise the song on high, the virgin sings her lullaby. Joy, joy, for Christ is born, the babe, the Son of Mary. Raise, raise, this is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing.
Gabriel was gone. The next morning, Joseph decided to talk to Mary.
Mary, I'm sorry for how I acted yesterday.
It's okay. I was shocked as well, but I know God will work this out for good.
He sure will. Ready to hit the road?
Yep, let's go.
Meanwhile, in a field, shepherds were tending to their flocks. All of a sudden, a bunch of angels poured into the sky.
Don't be afraid. I bring you good news. Today, a Savior is born named Jesus. He has come to save and love everyone.
And the multitude of angels was gone. Back at the inn.
Sorry, we're running out of time.
No room.
Ah.
Wait, I do have a yard.
A yard?
Now that I think about it, it has a feeding bucket too. It's all yours.
Thank you so much.
Joseph and Mary rushed to the stable. Mary had Jesus.
Where should we put the baby?
There. Sure.
downstairs, hope you had a good time as we fellowship with each other.